In March 2014, the first cases of Ebola were reported in Guinea. Within a few months, several countries and thousands of people were affected. Ebola has been known for close to 40 years, but when the epidemic broke out, there was no treatment and no vaccine due to a glaring lack of research into hemorrhagic fevers only affecting the developing world. Treatment was thus very limited and could not prevent the deaths of around 40% of those who contracted the disease. It wasn't until January 2015 that clinical trials on a range of potential treatments and vaccines were finally launched. Some of these trials could not be completed, while others were initiated too late to include enough patients. Regarding treatment, antibody-based ZMAP and antiviral favipiravir were the two drugs that stood out. But further research is needed to better document their efficacy. Only one vaccine was tested on a sufficient number of people in Guinea and produced excellent results. None of the people vaccinated immediately after being in contact with an Ebola patient had developed the disease 10 days later. This is the most promising news yet. It's the worst Ebola epidemic in history, with over 28,600 reported cases and 11,300 deaths. But if there's another outbreak, the only way to administer one of the potential treatments to patients would be through further clinical trials. Although no treatments or vaccines have been approved yet, responding to the epidemic has at least enabled health professionals to gain valuable experience. And there's still a lot of data to be analysed to advance knowledge of the disease and improve the response to future outbreaks. Take survivors of the disease. Médecins Sans Frontières is treating 350 of the 1,000 or so survivors living in Monserrado County, where Liberia's capital is. The most common longer-term effects of the disease are painful joints and ophthalmic disorders, as well as post-traumatic stress and depression. The few patients who have relapsed or contracted the infection from survivors of the disease have shown that the Ebola virus subsists in the body longer than it was previously supposed. For how long? Only consistent monitoring and long-term research will tell. Added to the challenge of ensuring post-epidemic surveillance, the healthcare systems of the three countries need to be re-established. Less than robust in normal times, they're now in a state of total collapse. In Liberia, 189 health workers died of Ebola. That's one in every 10. Numerous health facilities were forced to close, and many have still not reopened. And it's not just numbers of beds or personnel that pose a problem for healthcare systems. In the event of another outbreak, every clinic, every health centre, every hospital could once again be a source of infection if vital infection control measures are not properly implemented.